Recap Session 8. In this series, we are going to revise current affairs for prelims 2023. And here we are going to talk about international and national conferences held in 2022. Here are the list of 6 different conferences which are important for prelims. So we start with Shanghai Cooperation Organizations, RATS Anti-Terror Meet, which happened in Delhi in India. The regional anti-terror structure of SEO organized this particular anti-terror meet. And India has assumed the chairmanship of RATS SEO in 2021. So in 2022, it organized this particular meet. All the members, observers, and dialogue partners participated in this particular meet. You know, apart from Russia and China, India, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Pakistan, Tajikistan, and Uzbekistan were members, and Afghanistan, Belarus, Iran, and Mongolia are observers, whereas Azerbaijan, Armenia, Cambodia, Nepal, Turkey, and Sri Lanka are dialogue partners. So this is one of the most successful organizations in anti-terror operations. And RATS headquarters is based on Tashkent, and it's a permanent body of grouping and aims regarding the counter-terrorism, extremism, and separatism in this particular region. So this particular meet was happening in the background of the political developments in Afghanistan, Pakistan, and the Russian attack on Ukraine. And in this background, the terror meet happened. Then, Semicon India Conference. So this is one of the important conferences, the first global conference regarding the semiconductor. You know that with the Ukraine and Russia war, the semiconductor industry has been largely affected with the supply chain. And in this regard, in Bengaluru, we had the first global semiconductor conference with the theme Catalyzing India's Semiconductor Ecosystem. Was organized by India Semiconductor Mission. And this particular mission, which was launched by Meiti in 2021 for development of sustainable semiconductor ecosystem because of the global changing scenario and the digital India, which is going to pave a way for Indian development. So we had this program launched. And in this, we had the important RISE 5, Director 5 program launched, which is reduced instruction set computer variants. The processors were launched, and two set of processors were launched. One is Shakti, developed by IIT Madras. Another one is Vega, developed by CDAC, the Center for Advanced Computing. That Vega and Shakti of IIT Madras were launched. And this is one of the important needs. Which came up with a global range of semiconductor industries in India. The next important one is the first National Women Legislators Conference. So this is one important event which happened in May 2022. And one of the last programs which were launched by the former president of India. It was held in Thiruvananthapuram, and the conference was organized by Kerala Legislative Assembly. And here, the president showcased about the gender equality. It's important how the freedom struggle laid foundation for gender equality. And this can be one of the questions in main spot also. And the president also explain how national cooperation movement and national level movements like non-cooperation movement, Quit India movement, paved way for gender equality as well as participation. Special mentions were there on Kasturba Gandhi, Sarojini Naidu, Kamala Devi Chattopadhyay, Bikaji Kama, and Lakshmi Sehgal on contributions with regard to the freedom struggle. Further, the first lesson in gender equality was started by Hansa Ben Jivraj Mehta. So the information was also shared by the Honorable President. So for the first time in India, it happened in this particular way. And also check it out that the women participation or role in parliament, so which can also be a potential question in mains also. Okay. And in prelims, so gives some special reference to the women leaders mentioned by the presidents, that questions can be expected from their personal contributions to the freedom struggle. Then comes the 20th meeting of National Tiger Conservation Authority. And in this, the important thing is that apart from 20th meeting, for the first time it held outside the National Capital Territory. And it held in Pakhe Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. And this particular Tiger Conservation Authority meeting released a forest fire audit protocol for all tiger reserves, and also to obtain the first-hand information about the reserves and local issues. So it was conducted outside NCT. And to know about Pakhe Tiger Reserve, it's one of the important tiger reserve with respect to hornbill nest adoption program. In India, one of the largest hornbill nest adoption program successfully operated there. And more than 500 species of butterflies are native to this particular Pakhe Tiger Reserve. So this National Tiger Conservation Authority is a statutory body under Wildlife Protection Act 1972. And Union Minister is the one who acts as chairperson, and Minister of State acts as vice chairperson. And three other members of Parliament, Secretary, Ministry of Environment and Forest become the member of this particular Tiger Conservation Authority. So this is one of the important thing. And since it is 20th meeting and held outside Delhi for the first time, they can target Pakhe Tiger Reserve. They can ask about the Pakhe Tiger Reserve also. Then comes the first Incredible India International Cruise Conference. So it held in Mumbai, and it was conducted by Mumbai Port Authority. So it was aiming to develop India as a cruise hub. Recently, you know, the largest cruise route was opened up with the Ganga Vilas traveling across the national waterway. So similarly, India tries to become a world attraction with respect to cruise hub. So in this way, one of the such attempts were made by Incredible India campaign through International Cruise Conference. And we expect by 2024, Indira Dock Mumbai International Cruise Terminal would be opened up in Mumbai. So this is one important information which we get. Important conference what we have is the 4th Indo-Pacific Regional Dialogue. So this is one important forum, which is organized by National Maritime Foundation and held in New Delhi. And the most unique aspect is this. This is the first maritime think tank in India. And this particular Indo-Pacific Regional Dialogue, which was originally articulated in 14th East Asia Summit in 2019, later it was an initiative which happened to be one of the annual conferences organized by India. And thus the theme this year was Operationalizing Indo-Pacific Oceans Initiative, which was pioneered by India. And under this initiative, we have the focus area listed, and that we call it as maritime security, maritime ecology, maritime resources, disaster risk reduction and management, trade, connectivity and maritime transport, capacity building and resource sharing, science, technology and academic cooperation. So this is one of the important areas of focus in Indo-Pacific region among the countries what India envisages. So with this, we complete this particular session 8. For further updates, stay tuned with us. Thank you.